This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, let's start. Right, so yesterday we started with what internal tables. We have seen how to declare the internal table and how to fill the internal table data manually by using what append statement. And we created the internal table with header line and also without header line. Now, and we have seen different statements like describe statement. Okay, we have seen a loop statement, append statement. Okay, and we have seen the system field what site tabx. So we have seen different types of what statements. Now, let us see more statements. And we also discussed how to copy the data between what two internal tables by using append lines statement and by using what assignment operator. Right. So I'll give some title. Type of program is executable program. I'll save it in the local object. Done. So what is the standard way of declaring the internal table? First, we need to create what types declaration. Okay, in the types declaration, we need to declare the fields. So types begin of. Okay, I'll give the type name as something ty_emp. I'll take the same three fields, employee number, type I. Employee name of 20, type C. I'll declare another field, employee designation of 25, type C, and then end of what ty_emp. Right, so I created the types declaration. So based on this types declaration, let us create the internal table. Okay, so I'll create the internal table based on this. So I'll say data. Okay, I'll give the name of the internal table as something ty_emp1 type. Okay, type table of ty_emp. Okay, so yesterday what we have done, we have said what with header line. So what is the meaning? It will create the internal table with one default header. So now what I am doing is I am creating the internal table without any default header. Without any default header. So what is the understanding? The internal table will contain only the what body section. At this stage, this is my internal table ty_emp1, which has got three fields: employee number, employee name, employee designation. So this is the body of the internal table ty_emp1. Right, so this is ty_emp1. It contains only the body section. It doesn't have its own header. So if I say with header line, what happens? It will create the default header, but I am creating it without header now. So in order to fill the data in the internal table, as say what we have done, we cannot directly insert the data into the body. Okay, always we need to assign the data to the header, and from header we need to copy to what body by using what append statements. That's what we have done yesterday. Okay, so now I created the internal table without header. I'll try to assign the data, so it contains only the body. Now I'll say ty_emp1. Acha, before that, okay, so let me say ty_emp1-employee_5. Right, so what this will try to do, it will try to assign the data to the default header, but this internal table doesn't have any default header. Okay, and I cannot directly assign the data to the body area. At this stage, my internal table contains only the body area, doesn't have its default header. So when I try to assign like this, let's see what happens. when I do syntax check, yeah, I got an error. T underscore emp1 is a table without a header line. Okay, T underscore emp1 is a table without a header line and therefore has no component called as what? Employee number. So it is giving me a syntax error saying that the internal table doesn't have header line and it cannot recognize the component called as what? Employee number. Okay, so what this will try to do, it will try to, whenever you're doing the assignment will always try to do it in what? Header line. But we don't have any header for this internal table. That's why it is giving what? Syntax error. So let me comment this. Right, so it is giving me the syntax error. But what you have to do now, we have to fill the internal table manually. So since my internal table doesn't have any header, we need to declare an explicit header. We need to declare an explicit work area. I mean to say structure. Okay, so how do you declare a structure? Data, you can give any name, but generally in most of the projects, work area names will start with what? W underscore or LS underscore or GS underscore, something like this. Okay, so let me give a meaningful name. W underscore EMP type what is this? TY underscore EMP. So remember, I'm not using the table of keyword here. So if I don't use table of keyword, it is understood as what? Work area. So we are creating a separate header now. Okay, this header also, this work area also is created based on what? Same types declaration TY underscore EMP, which has got how many fields? Three fields. So what I did is I declared an explicit work area. Explicit means a separate work area based on the same types declaration. So what are the fields here? Work area also contains same fields. Internal table also contains what? Same fields, because both are created based on same types declaration. EMP number, employee name and employee designation, done. Okay, so what you have to do now, you need to assign the data to this work area. What is the work area name? W underscore EMP. From that work area, we need to append it to what? Body of the internal table. So let me, again, already we know before assigning any new data, you better clear the old data. If anything is there, it gets cleared, right? So I'm saying clear W underscore EMP. I'll assign the data. Right, so we are assigning the data to what? Work area. So in this work area is nothing but what? Header, nothing but a structure which can hold only what? Single record, 6 Raju and something what? Manager. So this record we need to copy to what? Body of the internal table. How do you copy? I'll say append W underscore EMP to T underscore EMP 1. So if you observe the difference in the yesterday's program, let me open that. I'll open a new session. I'll open the yesterday's program. Yeah, so in the yesterday's case, what you have done, we have created the internal table with header line. So it will create the default header. So when you are doing the assignment will be done in what? Header. And what you are saying is simply we are saying append T underscore EMP1. What this statement will do, it will try to copy the data from default header to the end of the internal table. So here also, okay, let me just comment this for the timing. I'll say append T underscore EMP1. So what is the behavior of this statement? It will try to copy the data from default header to the end of the internal table, but this T underscore EMP1 doesn't have its own header, doesn't have its default header. So when I do syntax check, I am getting an error. The internal table T underscore EMP1 has no header line, The work area WA2 must be specified explicitly. So this is giving you what? Syntax error, because it doesn't have its own default header. So what is the change you have to do? Like this, append W underscore EMP to T underscore emp1. So what it will do now, append statement will always copy the data from header, that is to the work area, to the end of, from the work area to the end of the internal state and end of the internal table. So what is this? 6 Raju and something what manager. So which statement is doing this task? Append statement. So we are saying append WA2 T underscore EMP1. Okay. Repeat this process for the rest of the records. Okay, so let me insert one more record, 12. Done. Okay, again, so when you clear the data in the work area, this gets cleared. Then the clear statement is executed, it will clear this old data. What is the new data we are assigning? 12 Ashok and what? Employee. So again, this will be 12 Ashok and then what? Something employee. What you are doing now, again, we are saying append W underscore EMP to T underscore EMP1. Again, the data is copied from work area to the end of the internal table. Append always refers to the end of the internal table. So this would be again 12 Ashok and something what employee. Let me copy one more record. Now this time let me say 16. And I'll say CEO. So when you say clear again, this would be removed. This will be overwritten. The old data would be cleared. We are assigning the new data. Okay, something like this. And again, we are using what? Append statement. So it will copy the data to the end of the internal table, something like this. 16 what Srinivas and then something CO. So I got the data. Okay, so as of now, my internal table has got some 3 records. How do we display it? In order to display it, again, we have to get each record from what? Body to what? Header. So I say what you have done. Okay, let me use some write statement. I'll say data in T underscore EMP1. So I say what we did simply. We said loop at T underscore EMP1 and end loop. Inside loop, end loop, we are using what? Write statement. Okay, so when I say loop at T underscore EMP1, what this T underscore EMP1 will do? It will populate the data from body. It will start from the first record. It populates the data from first record to the default header. But this internal table doesn't have its own header. So when I try to say like this, it will give an error. What is the error I'm getting? Internal table T underscore EMP1 has no header line. One of the additions into work area or assigning or reference into or transporting no fields is required. So it is saying that this internal table has no header line. So one of the additions, either of these additions has to be used. So this is giving me again what? Syntax error. Done. So what is the change I have to do? Loop at what is the internal table T underscore EMP1 into what is the work area name? W underscore what? EMP. So what the loop statement will do, already we know. Loop statement will start iterating from the first record. So from the first record, it will populate the data to what? It will populate the data to the header, something like this. Okay, so when it is populating, what is the first record here? 6 Raju and manager. So this old record will be overwritten in the work area. Again, the data would be populated. What is this? Something 6 Raju and what? Manager. So since it is successfully copied to header, successfully copied to the work area. Work area is nothing but what? Header here, explicit header. Since it is successfully populated, it will enter the loop. How do you refer to the work area data? Write statement. W underscore EMPFN employee number. W underscore EMPFN employee name. EMPFN employee designation. So when I print it, it will print the first record. Since it is a looping statement, since it is a looping statement, automatically cursor goes to what? Second record. Like this, how many times it will iterate? Three times, because we are having what? Three records, something like this. Okay, so what is the second record? 12 Ashok and what? Employee. So something like this. So this is 12, and assume this is what? Ashok, and assume this is something what? Employee. Okay, so like this, the data would be what? Populated. Done. Since it is successfully populated, again it will enter the loop. It will print the data in the current record in the work area, and again automatically cursor goes to what? Third record. It will populate that, populate the third record to the work area. So what is the third record here? Again 16, Srinivas and what? CEO. So assume this is 16, Srinivas and something what? CEO. Okay, so this is the data successfully populated. It will enter the loop, it will print it. I don't have further records to iterate. So what happened? Loop statement will fail. It will come out of the loop. So when I execute this, what is this? What is the work area name? W underscore EMPF and employee number. Here also W underscore EMPF and employee name and employee designation. No errors. So when I execute, yes, I got the data. Okay, let me quickly debug this. Okay, so after activating the program, let me debug from the executable statements. Up to this comes under declarations. We cannot debug the declarations. We can debug only executable statements. I'll put the breakpoint here. Done. Okay, so if you, what is the name of the internal table? T underscore EMP1. So if I double click on this, it is saying T underscore EMP1 is initial, means blank. As of now, the internal table doesn't have any data. I can check the content here also. I'll go to the table button here. I'll click on this. What is the internal table name? T underscore EMP1. So it is showing nothing. There is no data. And you can see here, yesterday we added the cap symbol, because in yesterday's case, the internal table contains its own default header. Now this internal table doesn't have its own default header. That's why I don't have any cap symbol. This is only the body, which is blank as of now. So what you are doing now, we are assigning the data to the work area first. Okay, so I'm assigning the data F5. How do we execute one statement at FM at a time? F5. So I got 6, Raju and manager. So the data is assigned to the work area. From work area, we are appending it to what? T underscore EMP1. Append will always copy the data to the end of the internal table. So when I say F5, has it copied here? Yes, it has copied. So what is that index position for the first record? 1. Like this, it will clear the data in the work area. Done. I got 12 Ashok and employee. Again, you are saying append. So it is successfully appended to what? End of the internal table. So like this, 3 records are what? Appended. Then I'm trying to display the data. Okay, we are trying to display the data in the internal table. When you're saying loop at T underscore EMP1, what is the first record here? 6, Raju and what? Man here. This will be copied to what? Header. That is to the work area, explicit work area. So when I say F5, what is the data in the work area earlier? 16, Srinivas and what? CEO. Loop will start from what? First record. So this old record will be overwritten with this first record. What is that? 6, Raju and manager. So when I say F5, yes, I got 6, Raju, manager, successfully copied to what? Header. It will enter the loop, it will print it. So I got the first record, 6, Raju and manager. Since it is a looping statement, automatically the cursor goes to second record. It will populate that record to the header. 12, Ashok and what? Employee. So when I say F5, yes, I got 12 Ashok employee. Like this, it will iterate for how many times? 3 times, because we're having 3 records. Now, since I don't have further records, see, when I say F5, it is coming out of the loop. Okay, so how this program is different from the yesterday's cases? In the yesterday's case, my internal table was having what? Its own default header. So when you do the assignment, the data would be assigned to the header. Directly from the header, we are appending it to the internal table by using the plain append statement. But in this case, our internal table is without header. So in order to populate the data in the internal table, we must consider the explicit work area, explicit structure, explicit header. So I declared what? An explicit structure, work area. Then first you assign the data to the work area. From work area, we append it to what? Internal table. So I got the data, something like this. Okay, so to copy the data to the internal table, what is the statement I'm using? Append statement. Okay, so as of now, we are having how many records? Some three records. Now what I'll do is, just observe this. I'll say clear W underscore EMP. Let me assign a new record. W underscore employee number is equal to, I'll say something 9. Okay, and also W underscore EMP if an employee name equal to, I'll say something, then W underscore EMP if an employee designation is equal to, I'll say supervisor. So if I use append statement, we know that it will add the record to the end of the internal table. That is understood. Now instead of using append statement, I'll try to use insert statement. Insert what? W underscore EMP into table. What is the internal table? T underscore EMP 1. Insert W underscore EMP into table T underscore EMP 1. So let us see what this insert will do. Okay, so how can you check it? Again, if you redisplay the internal table only, we will understand whether the data, whether the record is inserted into the internal table or not. Okay, so let me reprint it. Okay, so I'll just say uline data, okay, data in T underscore EMP1 after using what? Insert. Okay, this is only for understanding. I am giving the message. So I repeat once again. Here I use the append statement. We understood that append will always copy the data to the end of the internal table. So at this stage, we got three records. Now I am inserting one more record by using what? Insert statement. I want to check whether this record is inserted at the end of the internal table or somewhere else in the internal table. So for that reason, again, I'm looping it. Again, it will start iterating from the first record and displays it. So let's see. So what is that record we insert here? 9, right? Let me check it now. When I execute, good. So see here, earlier we have three records. Okay. Now I'm using the insert statement. Again, I got what? 9. Where this 9 got inserted? 9 got inserted at the end only, now. Understood? So at this stage, what is the understanding? Both append and insert are inserting the records to the end of the internal table. Understood? What is the last record I inserted by using insert statement? 9. So I got what? 9 here in the last position. Now see the advantage of insert statement. Let me insert one more record. I'll insert one more record. I'll say 11. Okay, something like this. Now I'll say insert W underscore EMP, okay, into T underscore EMP 1. I'll say index 4. Index 4, or I'll say index what? 2. Am I clear? So what I'm trying to say, insert W underscore EMP into T underscore EMP 1 index 2. So let me check whether it has inserted this employee number in the second position or not. So let me, again, if you loop it only, then only we'll understand where it got inserted. Data and T underscore EMP 1 after using insert. After using insert with what? Index something. Okay, so I'm trying to insert this employee number 11 at which position? Second position. Let me check whether it is inserted or not. When I execute, yes, you can see now what, where this employee number 11 got inserted in the second position. Understood? This is the advantage of what? Insert statement. So to summarize, this is what kind of internal table? Standard internal table, as we have seen. By default, the internal table type is what? Standard. If you don't specify the type of internal table, by default, you'll take it as what? Standard. So on the standard internal table, I can use both append statement as well as what? Insert statement. Append statement will always insert the data at the end of the internal table, whereas insert statement can be used either to insert the data to the end of the internal table or in a specific position by using what addition? Index addition. So I got that employee number 11 in which position? Second position. Done. So any questions so far, please ask me. Okay, done. Now, so we understood some points related to what standard internal table. What is that? For standard internal table, I can use both append and what insert statement to copy the data. Append will always insert the data to the end of the internal table, whereas insert can be used either to insert at the end of the internal table or in a specific position. So when you are using insert statement, if you are not using the index keyword, it will always insert at the end, just like append. Okay, but I can use index also along with what insert. I cannot use index with append. Append always refers to what end of the internal table. So at this stage, if you see this T underscore EMP1, what is the data? Something like this 6, 11, 12, 16, and what 9. 6, 11, 12, 16, and 9. So this is not sorted, remember. This is not sorted on employee number. Okay, 9 should come in the second position. So in whatever the sequence I inserted, I got in the same sequence. Now what I'll do is, just try to understand. I'll declare one more internal table, data T underscore EMP2 type. TY underscore EMP, just try to understand. So far, we are declaring the standard internal table something like this. Type table of what? TY underscore EMP. This is the way we are declaring the internal table so far. Now I'll say, okay, data T underscore EMP to type table of TY underscore EMP. So while declaring these internal tables, while declaring the internal tables, we can specify the key field. I repeat. While declaring the internal tables, we can specify the key field. Okay, that key can be either unique key or non-unique key. That key can be unique key or non-unique key. Unique key means which doesn't accept duplicate values. Non-unique key means which can hold what duplicate values. Okay, I repeat. While declaring the internal tables, I can specify the key field. Okay, the key field can be either unique or what non-unique. So this is what kind of internal table? Standard internal table. Na? So when I declared the first standard internal table, did I mention any key here? No. So what is the meaning? I can create the standard internal table either with the key or without key. Means key declaration is not mandatory. Key declaration not mandatory for my standard internal table. I can create it without key or with key. So for the first internal table, I am creating it without key. Now for the second internal table, I'll try to say with unique key, with the unique key employee number. So let me check whether unique key is supported for what? Standard internal table or not. So when I do syntax check, good. So I got an error. You can only use unique with the table types what hashed and what sorted. Means I cannot use unique addition with what standard internal table. So this is giving me what syntax error. So let me comment it. Data T underscore EMP2 type table of so and so. I'll try to say what non-unique key. I'm trying to say what non-unique key. Let's see whether it's accepted or not. When I do syntax check, yes, it is accepting the non-unique key. So I repeat once again, for standard internal tables, key specification is not mandatory. Means I can create it either without key or with key. In the first case, I created without key. In case if you want to give the key, what kind of key I can give? Only what? Non-unique key. Means standard internal table doesn't support what? Unique key. So what I gave here? Non-unique key. Okay. So to summarize, T underscore EMP1 doesn't have any key field, whereas T underscore EMP2 contains what? Key field. Now what I'll do is just observe here. I want to copy the data from EMP1 to what? EMP2. So how do you copy? Both the internal table structure is same now. Both the internal tables are created based on same types declaration. Since the structure is same, also what? Append, or I can use assignment operator. Append what? Lines of, append lines of T underscore EMP1 to T underscore EMP2. I am copying the data from EMP1 to what? EMP2. So let me cross check whether it is copied or not. Again, you can see T underscore EMP2 also is what? Without header. It is also what? Without header. Without header. Okay, so I'll just, sorry, let me print it. Data in what? T underscore EMP2 after copying data from T underscore EMP1. This is only just meaningful message. So I'm just giving a message here, right? So loop at T underscore what? EMP2 now. Understood? I copied the data to what? T underscore EMP2. I want to check the data in T underscore EMP2. Since this is also without header, I require a separate structure, separate work area. I'm populating each record to work area. Let me display it. When I execute, yes, you can see T underscore EMP2, what? The data is copied. So you can see both T underscore EMP1 as well as T underscore EMP2 has got the same data. 6-11-12-16-9. Okay. Now let us understand the concept of key now. So at this stage, both T underscore EMP1 and T underscore EMP2 has got the same data, same sequence. Everything is same. But the difference is T underscore EMP1 is without key, whereas T underscore EMP2 contains what? Non-unique key. What is that non-unique key? Employee number. Now, see this. I'll say, try to understand. So, once again, see, what is the data in T underscore EMP1? This is the data. This is the current data in T underscore EMP1. Now, on this internal table, I'll try to use sort statement. Sort. T underscore EMP1. What is the purpose of sort statement? It is used for arranging the data in an order. Okay. But I'm not specifying based on what field it has to sort. My internal table contains three fields: employee number, employee name, employee designation. We are not specifying the field name on which it has to sort. So let's see what happens now. So let me reprint it. Data in T underscore EMP1 after what? Default sort. After default sort. Why I'm saying default sort? Because I'm not specifying the field name. So let me loop the first internal table. Understood? So I'm sorting the internal table, but I'm not telling SAP on which field it has to sort. So let me check on which field it has sorted. So again, I'm looping the first internal table and redisplaying. So let us see that. Yeah, if you scroll down, yeah, observe these two. This is okay. 1 second, please. Just let me give the colors so that you can easily identify. So for T underscore EMP1, I'll give format color 3 and I'll switch off the color. Okay, and for T underscore EMP2, I'll give some other color. I'll switch off the color. Again, for T underscore EMP1, I'll give the similar color, format color 3. I'll switch off the color. Okay, so just observe here. So T underscore EMP1 is color 3, yellow color, right? If you see T underscore EMP1 focuses, this is the data. What is that? Actual data is what? 6, 11, 12, 69. Now I use a sort on T underscore EMP1. Yeah, you can observe now, is the data is sorted here? Yes, it has sorted. But you can see here, it has not sorted on employee number. It has not sorted on the employee number. It has sorted on the employee name. It has sorted on the employee name. It has sorted on employee name. So what is the understanding? You are telling sort T underscore EMP1, but we are not telling on which field it has to sort. On which field it has to sort. So it is sorting on what? It is sorting on what? Employee name. So what is the meaning is, if you don't specify the sorting field, if you don't specify the sorting field, SAP will check whether this internal table contains any key field. SAP will check whether this internal table contains any key field. This T underscore EMP1 doesn't have any key declaration. So since it doesn't have any key declaration, it will check what is the first character field in the internal table. How many character fields are there in the internal table? Two character fields, employee name and employee designation. So it is sorting on what? Employee name, because it is the first character field. I repeat once again, whenever we use a sort statement without mentioning the sorting field, what happens? SAP will check whether the internal table contains any key specification field. If the key specification field is available, it is going to sort on that. But this T underscore EMP1 doesn't have any key field. So what happens? What is the next priority? It will sort on the first character field. Do we have any character fields in my internal table? Yes, I'm having the first character field is what? Employee name. Assume that my internal table doesn't have any character fields. All are numeric fields. So at that time, it is going to sort on what? First field. So what is the sequence it will try to check? It will check whether the internal table contains any key specification field. If it contains, it is going to sort on that. Otherwise, it will try to sort on what? First character field if available. If there are no character fields, it is going to sort on first field of the internal table. So in this case, in T underscore EMP1, it is sorting on what? First character field, which is employee name. Now I'll try to use a sort statement and what? T underscore EMP2. What is the data in T underscore EMP2 at this stage? 6, 11, 12, 69. I'm going to use a sort statement based on T underscore EMP2. So I'll say here, sort T underscore EMP2. Again, here also, I'm not specifying any sorting field. So if you don't specify any sorting field, data in T underscore EMP2 after what? Default sort, after default sort. So again, the same sequence. Since I didn't specify any sorting field, it will check whether this internal table contains any key specification field. Yes, T underscore EMP2 contains one key specific, forget about whether it's unique or non-unique. It contains what? Key field. What is the key field? Employee number. So it is going to sort on what? Employee number. Okay, so see now when I execute, let me check. Yes, you can observe now. This is the old data. Now you can see it has sorted out.